welcome to the Goods from the Woods. My name is Rivers Langley.
I'm Sam Harder.
And I'm Carter Glasscock.
And today we are so pleased to be joined by comedian and also the star of one of my all-time favorite web series, Thug Notes. Oh, it's our friend Sparky Sweets, PhD, a.k.a.
Greg Edwards.
Welcome to the show, Greg.
Thank you, Rivers.
Hell yeah.
Thank you guys for having me.
Oh, of course, man. Yeah. I've been wanting to do this for a long time.
Yeah, I've known you for a long time.
Yeah, Rivers. Man.
I'm sorry we haven't done this.
Hey, man, we're here now.
I'd like to tell a story that one time I was on a date and we were trying to figure out what to watch. And the girl chose that series of videos.
No shit. Oh, that's awesome.
And I was like, oh, I know this guy. She was not impressed.
Oh. One bit.
Sorry,
that's
Sam.
Not a, yeah,
like, you're
that's
lying.
Not a comment on you. That's just me thinking she would be impressed. Like, oh, I know the guy from the YouTube video.
Yeah, yeah. I know Greg.
Man.
Oh, that's nice, man. I thought I could have got you laid, though.
I had already done that.
Okay. Well, good.
She knew it was Greg, yeah.
Got you a second date burrito.
Oh, yeah. Hey. Yeah, there
That's
we go.
Actually, more important to me.
I sent that series to my. I think I told you this. I sent that series to my high school English teacher when those first started coming out because I was like, "This is just so fucking great." Because it really did hit to what I always said about education, where it's just like this shit is interesting. You just have to be able to, you know, tell people.
Explain it.
Yeah.
And break it down for kids.
And in a fun way. And totally. My English teacher, because as far as I know, it's like totally, totally clean web series. Yeah. He was showing them to like his classes.
I get
and
it
stuff.
All the time. People, teachers still hit me up. I was at my, my niece's, she's my niece. I was at her wedding probably a couple of months ago. And I get there and all of her groomsmen are just like young dudes. So they were just like, yo. And I was like, oh, really? Okay. Yeah. Cool. They want to take pictures. It's like, guys, this is weird.
Yeah.
Just look after my niece.
Yeah. Yeah. That fucking rocks. Like I said, it sort of goes the same way with history too, where I'm just like, the shit is interesting.
Yeah.
It's just
somebody gotta drop it on them.
But
Rivers is like the really like harried like substitute teachers, like, come on guys, pay attention. This is interesting stuff.
Man, they never let me substitute anything fun. I was always substituting for math, and like my math knowledge does drop out around eighth grade, so I was literally like, boy, I hope these kids don't ask me how to divide fractions because I don't fucking remember.
That's hard. How long were you subbing for? Are you still subbing?
No. Okay, this is my weird lost year between graduating college and starting to do comedy. Where mm-hmm. I decided to quit subbing to make some real money delivering steaks so I could move to California.
Door-to-door steaks? Hell yeah. I know so many comedians that used to do that.
Well, this was much stupider than what you're imagining, because what you're thinking of is like frozen steaks, like an Omaha steak.
Yeah.
This was a steakhouse that delivered.
Oh, wow.
So this was like cooked, and these dickheads would order like, I want mine rare, but you put it in foil and put it in my bag for a cook.
And it's 40 minutes away.
Yeah, it's going to be medium.
Like, right.
So it was, I've told this before, but it was a place that was owned by a former police officer.
Okay.
And it was called Stakeout.
Stakeout.
Yeah. So
Good night.
And they still have one location, as far as I know, in Huntsville, Alabama. And the
Booster Steakhouse.
Hey, yeah, that's me, bud. But yeah, last time I was in Huntsville, I was staying in a hotel. Like, I was doing stand up, and I was like, should I do it? I was like, all right, got to do it for old time's sake. So I did order steakout.
Hell yeah, was it good?
Yeah, I mean, it was fine.
Of course, it's like no one you knew works there anymore. Oh, it's like that rotating cast.
Well, this was the Huntsville location, the one that I worked at. I, left. I was like, all right, guys, I'm moving to California. See you later. And then in my head, I'm like,
bullshit.
Well, no. In my head, I was thinking like, oh, this would be great. You know, someday I'll come back here. I'll get myself a burger and we'll talk about old times. And they had closed by the time I got to the West Coast. They had fucking went out of business.
How many were there? Were there just two?
There was one in Auburn and there was one in Huntsville. And I believe there was one in like Birmingham, Tuscaloosa.
Yeah, there was one in Tuscaloosa. I remember Stakeout for
Cops
sure.
Getting that money.
Yeah.
That is Sergeant Dave.
Yeah.
I like how like you had like this fantasy of like, I'm going to go back and have a burger with them. Not like you're going to like shove it in their face. Like you're a success.
No. Well, because I worked there with them. It was great. It was one of those great fuck around businesses where I went to high school with everybody there. So we were all just in cahoots to fuck around as much as possible. Yeah. So,
dude,
you know,
I might be having a brain fart. I think I may have worked at Steakhouse for like a second. Seriously? I totally forgot.
Is that working the same one?
Dude, I don't know. Maybe we did. I've when you said there was a steakout in Birmingham, I was like, oh yeah, I guess there was. Did I fucking work at that steakout for like a day?
Yeah.
Did not deliver it right, I guess. I guess I fucked it up.
They fucked it up.
Yeah. Man. I don't. Someone worked at a stakeout, and it was very close to me. I don't know. I feel like I was just told I was adopted. I gotta go quit the podcast and go sit in the bathroom for a while.
Was it all delivery? I know we're talking about steak.
Oh no, that's fine.
Was it all delivery? Well,
our store was the only store that in the whole company that had a lobby.
Okay,
and these freaks would show up on Sunday and order. We had the biggest steak. I think it was like a 42-ounce ribeye. Damn. It was called the Ribosaurus.
Okay.
These fucking people would show up, order a, it'd be like 7-person family. They would order 7 ribosauruses. Wow. Well done.
Jesus.
And then they would proceed.
That's a lot of chewing.
No, right? And then they would proceed to pour ketchup and mayonnaise on it and then rub it in with like a fucking butter knife and then just eat it and then just leave the most amount of trash you can imagine. Wow. So every Sunday.
In the small lobby?
Yeah. So we just see them walking in. We're just like, God. Damn it.
like the name is steak out. You can get this out.
Yeah. Go home.
That's a good ass business. That's a man's business too. I got an idea. How about we start a steak to go place?
Yeah.
But not here.
They gotta leave though.
You know that food that's really dependent on temperature. Let's wrap it in tinfoil and fucking styrofoam.
No muss, no fuss.
Move it around the town.
When you're covering it in ketchup and mayonnaise, just go to Jack in the Box.
Just right? Or anywhere.
Not at all.
Just go anywhere.
Yeah.
And we'd watch him do it too. What? It was like it was like a horrifying ritual. Or just like up here. Oh, he's going for it. He's going for the man. Oh, he's going. Oh, look what they're going to do. The ketchup. Oh,
a steak is. I think Americans judge people. Judge steak eaters so wildly, you know what I mean? Because we always judge, well done. That says so much about you.
Yeah,
you know, it's just the condiments you use on a steak, how you cut it. We judge so much about steaks. I like it though.
But it's like the same people as it's same thing as people who drink wine. It's like just a bunch of people pretending like they know what they're talking about. You know what I mean? It's like people are like, oh, you get it, well done. Huh? You have no idea for the nuances of the cow blood.
Yeah.
And the same thing with wine too. It's like people are just like, yes, I like it. The older is better. The oldest year of on that cab. And they have no fucking idea what they're talking about. Like, this is fancy. I know fancy things.
I want the wine with the Rolling Stones logo on it from 1992.
I hold my pinky
Lounge
out.
Tour.
It's all the logo, right?
Yeah.
I mean, Trader Joe's, it's all the logo.
Yeah, Tupac Chuck. Yeah.
It's just a logo. I was like, oh, I want the cute one.
Yeah.
That one's purple. I like the font on that wine bottle right there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we talked about...
Helvetica.
Yeah. We talked about a few years ago, they had the Undertaker wine from WWE, and that one almost got me. I didn't quite bite on it, but came real close.
Fermented in coffin?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Cask-aged.
Cask-aged. Yeah.
I assume a lot of Undertaker fans drink wine.
I know, right?
I can see that.
Yeah. Speaking of drinks, figure we could roll out this week's ungodly concoction, and of course, this is from Ray's. This blind squirrel found a nut, and that was Ray's Baja Lime, which is the best energy drink on the market. Everything else they do is fucking awful. So I am very, very curious, but this flavor cracked me up because on the side, it very clearly says not recommended for people under 18, as all energy drinks do. But the flavor is...
What was that? Juice Box.
Juice box.
Juice box. Come
yes,
on, man.
That's right. Not for children, but the flavor is simply juice box. Juice box.
With the juice box on the back, right?
Yeah, but
this is like a Dave and Buster's kind of experience. This isn't Chuck E. Cheese. All right, people are getting drunk on this shit.
It's got apples, so I assume that's like the flavor they're going for. But that's just the fact that it is simply tastes like juice box.
Juice box. Zero sugar.
Is it carbonated?
Well, I don't know. We're gonna have to find out, aren't we?
I do like the black top.
Yeah.
The can has a cool design.
It does.
Yeah. No.
Trying to get the kids.
Graphic designer went hard.
They should have a flavor called Recess.
I mean, that's kind of what this is,
homework
right?
Homework stinks.
The homework stinks.
Yeah. No, I
skateboarding tricks.
I did notice on their website they have the phrase raising the bar. It's spelled like the drink, R-A-Z-I-N-G. Raise Energy takes a giant leap of faith with instilling a high quality formula. And I think that when Raise was created, these people did not know that the word R-A-Z-E was already a word, and they just thought they were spelling the word R-A-I-S-E in a cool way.
I think before we record, we brought up an interesting point. Like, all of these are definitely written by ChatGPT now. 100%.
Yeah.
Sure. Copywriters are going to lose their jobs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
But if they're
everybody
selling,
is.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
If they're selling this chemical sludge, I kind of understand it. It's like, you don't need a bard's touch to describe this
that was
shit.
So clear.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, guys.
Unlike grab a one. Juice box, it is carbonated.
We're all going to die.
Cheers, everyone. Yeah. Cheers.
Smells
cheers,
like
cheers.
Apple juice.
Smells like apple juice?
Does smell like apple juice. Okay. Yeah.
Oh. Tastes like shit.
It does.
That's not
it
great.
Tastes like it tastes bad, and then it tastes like nothing.
Yeah,
yeah. It tastes like that top layer of the apple juice smell, mm-hmm. and then just nothing underneath. Yeah,
you should have shook this up.
Yeah, hosed us down like Victory Lane.
Yeah. I'm gonna mix some of mine with this.
You're gonna cut it down.
There you go.
Oh, there we go. Cut it. Yeah. Maybe
that'll help. It's probably you need to put like an aerator on the top of this. Get a little air in it.
Get an emulsion blender.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just press it a couple times.
Now, what is the function of this? Is this gaming liquid or what? What is this?
Raise is a part of a rep, which is like a supplement thing. So this is more of a kind of a gym flavored one. Yeah,
it's pre-workout.
Well, rep sells pre-workouts, and then Raise is like I said, the only other flavor that's just is Apollo, which is their like bomb pop flavor.
Blue.
It's just okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
But then, like I said, the Baja Lime is the best energy drink in the world. Hard stop. Okay. So what is your energy drink regimen, if any, Greg?
If I'm gonna do an energy drink, it's always Red Bull.
Okay.
That's just the one that's always around.
Right.
I'm not buying energy drinks. But I will do a Red Bull.
Yeah.
If I'm shooting something, if I have to shoot something, which I haven't shot in a while, I'm not bragging or anything.
Right, let's blame the strike.
Yeah.
No, it's definitely not for the strike for me.
It's a strike podcast.
Yeah.
But yeah, Red Bull's around and I'll do it. Like if I'm doing a club or if I'm doing comedy at a club and they got Red Bull and it's a late show, I will pound a Red Bull.
Yeah,
just to have a little more energy on stage.
Yeah, that is nice.
And they have those like their own like coolers, really.
Exactly,
the Red Bulls, right?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Rivers generally find stuff at like gas stations.
I'll find gas stations, and I'll go. If you really want to look for the esoteric of the energy drink world, Vitamin Shop, GNC,
Vitamin Shop,
local store, Get Yoked in the Valley.
Get Yoked?
Yeah, that's what it's called.
That's wild how many energy drinks there are, though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's we've been doing this every show since 2020.
I would love to know how many, like, dick energy pills there are. You know, like Rooster
Stoner energy? Yeah,
yeah, like,
probably.
You know, I want to know how many different pills there are for your dick.
It's been discussed many times by me on this podcast.
Yeah.
A lot of these shit is the same shit that's in a gas station boner pill.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's just a bunch of random.
So that's why I'm horny like every time we do this.
That's what I was thinking.
I mean, Jesus.
Is it mostly ginseng in there?
No, that's like the old school gas station boner pill in the aluminum foil pouch.
7-Eleven.
Yeah.
After every episode, I have to like go run to the doctor with a full boner. What is wrong with me?
Then
he flicks it. He's like, "You're fine." Yeah, it's the doctor who lives right outside. He just flicks my boner and he's like, "You're fine."
Yeah, this is not good.
Yeah.
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 I mean, it's not horrible.
That's
it doesn't
not
have
that
like
bad.
That super off-putting flavor. flavor, but nothing about it is good.
Yeah, it's like how I feel about all of Raise's products.
Some of these, like, I'll feel like 15 minutes later.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Delayed fuse.
Yeah, delayed fuse.
Drinks work pretty fast.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah.
I drink them regularly, and by the time I drink like a fourth or third of one, I'm already going.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. By the time I'm drinking my fifth, I'm really, really feeling it.
Yeah. What's in that cup, Rivers? Be honest. What's in that cup?
It might be a Diet Mountain Dew.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. So now, the OG, if we're talking OG energy drinks.
Now, now Greg,
it is the beginning of energy
that's
drinks.
That's right.
Oh, for sure. Mountain Dew is, the branding and everything, like the fake, like, it's good for you, but it's got lots of sugar and
shit. It's badass.
Yeah, it's badass, though.
I should have cleaned anything, too.
Yeah, that's right.
I used to work at a Wendy's when I was in high school, and the grill would get hella, like, crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And I remember, like, my first week there, one of my buddies was like, yo, just pour Mountain Dew all over it. And let it sit for, like, 5 minutes and scrape.
Yeah.
And shit worked like a charm.
Yeah, yeah, that does work.
I wonder what that is. Off.
Yeah, it's the citric acid.
Yeah.
Because, the grill I worked at once, we used lemon juice to clean it. So no chemicals were allowed, so you'd squirt lemon juice on the grill, and that would do the trick. But, yeah, it's the citric acid in there.
Yeah.
So the preservatives, the things that allow Mountain Dew to stay on your shelves forever.
I was going
to
say, like, you degrease a pan, but it also can degrease the lining of your stomach.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Greg, do you have, like, a limit of, like, caffeinated things you'll drink before you go on stage? Or are you, like...
I mean, these days, I'm sober, right? Not
right.
Bragging. Kind of hate it. I had to do it. It is the worst.
Hey, well, good for you.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it's been the best. But
How often are you bored all day long?
No, it's not that I'm bored. It's that I've had to learn to, like, deal with my frustrations with life.
Yeah.
Like, the world just could beat you in the face, and you just gotta, like, you know, figure out a way to deal with it. But within that, I drink a lot of ginger ale.
Mm-hmm.
I drink Coca-Cola and coffee.
Okay,
so those are like my caffeine things.
Nice.
Okay. Yeah. Okay,
but I don't go really hard before I go on stage. Maybe that Red Bull only for like a late show.
Yeah.
Okay. But I love a Coke though. I do Coca-Cola. almost every night. I do one soda a night. Yeah.
I'm gonna try to track down a couple of Baja Limes. I'll bring them to the show Friday.
Let me know, man. I'll try that.
You can sample the real stuff. I feel very let down by this juice box flavor, but
it's all right.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's just absolutely whatever.
I'm kind of relieved. It's just all. There's nothing to it. When it tastes like farts, it makes me feel like I'm tripping. I'm like. I want to die and move back.
We've had some gnarly ones.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Some of them make me want to move back.
It's like cheese. It's like cheese and shit. You just never know what you're going to get.
I want to return to the womb.
It's like sometimes they just put all the boner pill ingredients.
Yeah.
They forget. They, like, skip out on the flavoring.
Yeah.
All the money on the herbal supplements.
It's like the suggestion of armpit. Like, it's just fucking... this is, like, mild. This tastes just bland.
Yeah.
I'm fine with it. Bland for an energy drink.
It's how much caffeine is in it?
200 mg in a Raise,
which is like how many coffee cups?
Two point five cups of coffee, something like that.
Okay,
yeah. So nothing that that wild.
All right.
Are you guys coffee drinkers?
Oh yeah,
slaves to the coffee. To the bean.
In the wintertime.
In the wintertime.
Yeah. Every morning, huge cup of cold brew keeps me regular.
It's temperature dependent. You know,
I get that.
We're like almost to the point. Actually, I had a cup of tea this morning. So yeah.
Oh, you're a tea guy.
We're there. Yeah, I'll do tea or I'll do coffee. I mean,
classy,
not picky.
Like,
yeah, I get the lemon lift.
I do drink more caffeine when I'm like trying to be sober for like a month or something.
Yeah.
Like I need something.
I need a hit of something.
Yeah, it's like, and like a cup of coffee, like midday cup of coffee. Like, all right, I can kind of fuck with this.
Cold brew is the truth, though. I remember when cold brew like started.
Yeah.
People were like crackheads about that shit.
It is, you should meet Chris Croft.
I was going to say, you should meet Chris.
How you make cold brew is kind of crackish. It's kind of like drug dealer-ish.
It's the dab of coffee.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's really distilled. Wild. Heavily distilled.
It's distilled coffee. It's wild. It's like coffee's already been in the factory. Like, it's been fucked with and burnt up.
Right.
And then we just doing another process to it to make it very...
I was making my own at one point at home.
Your own cold brew?
When I lived at Austin, because you can just put coffee grounds and water and strung it out, you know?
Yeah.
And I'd drink like one of those big mason jars.
Sure.
I started making them that size, and since I would have it around, I would just like drink it all in a day and just shake and sweat.
Dude, I slam like a venti cold brew from Starbucks and like don't even like think about it.
Get so used to it, it doesn't do it.
I'll have a massive headache the day I don't do that.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Oh, Jesus.
But the whole world is addicted to coffee, though, and we're cool with it.
Yeah.
I mean, oh, yeah.
It's
yeah.
good, though. I mean, I fucking love it.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
There's some sort of berry they chew and like, or nut they chew in the majority of the world. I forget what it's called. Yeah. It gets you a little buzz and it ruins your teeth and gums.
Oh,
like, you look fucking crazy.
It's not Argentina, but it's somewhere where the women wear those hats too, those cool ass Pharrell hats. What I'm talking about? Is it Peru? I think it's Peru where they chew like this like coffee bean or like leaf.
Okay.
That has like a cocaine in or something in it.
Oh, yeah. It's like coca bean or something. Like, yeah.
I think so.
Yeah. Oh, man. Well, yeah, I guess Rays, keep trying. That's all I got to say to Rays. Yeah. Maybe.
I think we stopped rating them, but I'll be like 2.5.
That's what I'm going to. Yeah, that's exactly where I'm putting it.
I think Rays might. You just got to accept this is a one-hit wonder.
I know.
Stop buying their new stuff.
I know. This is the Gangnam style of energy drinks. So no other hits coming. I have a story I wanted to share with you guys. This is out of Duluth, Georgia, just outside of Atlanta. And this actually comes from a couple of articles. Jordan Pearson writing for Vice, Sabrina Tapa writing for The Street, and Protos.com. Crypto. It's not doing so hot these days, and neither is one of the industry's most bombastic influencers. Ben Armstrong, who was previously known as BitBoy. He is, I'll show you a picture just for context. And I should say that the car that he is standing in front of here will become important
a
moment.
That's a bit, man. I'll tell you right now.
So, you know, go ahead and describe that guy for me.
Like he creeps out women.
Yeah,
sure. Not even by talking to him, just his general presence.
Just by being in the line at the grocery store.
He is definitely like 47. He's got some salt in that pepper.
Absolutely. Oh,
yeah. He's got a green tracksuit on.
It looks expensive. But trashy still somehow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
He's shirtless a lot too.
He's
just shirtless for no reason.
And he doesn't have the body for it.
Not at all, but he doesn't care. No. Rich shirtless.
Armstrong was the face of the popular crypto YouTube brand BitBoy, as we mentioned, and he is a flamboyant presence in the crypto industry.
Are there subtle presences in the crypto industry?
That's the thing, is like when you see what this guy looks and sounds like, you're like, there's a different world where you're just a boring guy, but like being in the industry that he's in, those being YouTube and crypto, just forced him into acting like a insane person.
Okay.
So he's fond of expensive sunglasses, designer tracksuits, and luxury cars. He made multiple posts on his Instagram about a Lamborghini Huracan that he calls his baby. So in YouTube videos under the BitBoy moniker, he shoots guns and receives sets of crypto inspired teeth grills. There's a lot
crypto
of
teeth grills.
He's got like a grill, and I think it's got like the Ethereum logo and the Bitcoin logo and all this shit on the teeth. It's incredible.
Wow. Paul Wall, cut this guy off.
Yeah.
Custom pieces.
It's kind of biting riffraff style a little bit too.
A little bit. Well, we're gonna get into some hip hop as it relates to this guy.
Biting a 10 to 20 year old style for sure.
Oh yeah, yeah. So one of his videos is titled "Insane Millionaire Joyrides Kids Bikes in Target," and then parentheses for charity. So,
I guess he's not doing this for himself.
No, he's walking around. He's doing laps around Target on the little girl's bicycle.
Where is he at? Where does this guy live?
So in Georgia, in Atlanta.
Oh, Duluth. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. So he's an Atlanta guy. Everything changed, though, in late August when the Hit Network, a crypto media company that owns his brands, ousted Armstrong and alleged that he suffered from diet pill abuse, roid rage, and they also allege emotional, physical, and financial damage. So
he's taking the gas station bonus.
Yeah,
pills.
Exactly.
Oh, wow. Yes.
He's getting buzzed off of all of them.
I just love
that. He's on roids and he looks like that, too.
That's
what happens when you eat the roids and then you just like binge watch a season of fucking Seinfeld.
I mean, I will say every time I've, you know, had like some kind of viral infection, got shut up with steroids, you feel great that day, but it doesn't make me want to work out. Just makes me want to just hang out and have a great day.
There is a comedian I know who bought steroids and then thought you didn't have to work out.
Oh, that's awesome.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
He talks about it on stage. Shout out to Seth Plummer.
Okay.
Right. Wow. I used to...
Seth, I haven't seen Seth in a while.
Me neither.
I used to go to the gym and get like a protein shake, like a peanut butter protein shake. And then I would get on the treadmill for like 15 minutes and I'd be like, why am I gaining weight? Because I would eat 500 calories and then like burn maybe 75 calories.
When we first got Smoothie King in my town, you know, everybody, this is the late 90s. So people are just like, smoothies are good. You can just drink them all. They're great for you.
Right.
And they had one that was called the Hulk. And it was like a peanut butter and chocolate protein smoothie with like... Jesus. Fucking probably 1500 calories in it. And I was just, you know, I'm a little fat child and I'm just like, oh, obviously this is good for me. The Hulk's good for me. And I drank those all the time and I gained so much fucking weight that summer.
It is literally like Cartman doing the beefcake thing.
Yes, yes. I did that.
Yeah, I did it when I was like a drunk 20-year-old.
Yeah. I was like, it's just protein. This is good for your muscles.
Yeah, yeah.
Shit is so tasty.
I love the way they drew Cartman just getting fatter too. It was so hilarious.
God damn. Yeah, also I like the note that it says it's for diet pills is that he's addicted to and not just saying cocaine.
He has a public image to maintain.
I suppose.
Well, they added him for the roids, so
yeah, that's true.
I really do think it's not he's literally taking gas station level. People get hooked on that shit. They really do.
Jeez.
BitBoy claims...
Insane millionaire develops addiction to gas station pills. For charity.
what charity?
Hi, I'm BitBoy. Welcome to Jackass.
I only take Exxon pills. That's it. Yeah. None of the Citgo shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Exxon.
Citgo, that's Venezuela. Fuck that. I want American shit.
Do I look like an Arco guy to you? No.
So BitBoy claims to have lost everything after he got kicked off, and he previously reached out to his audience of thousands to garner thousands of dollars in donations. So this guy ends up raising about $40,000 in donations from like crypto idiots that feel bad for him, and you're like, he's already rich though.
I was say,
but he lost everything, right?
Supposedly.
All right, you know,
those are the easiest people to get money from.
Obviously,
just be like, no, they judged me because I was yelling at everyone from steroids.
Yeah, yeah.
I've been fucking wrongfully convicted. And they're like, yeah, my wife says that all the time.
$40,000.
So Armstrong alleges that the BitBoy brand was wrongfully taken from him and that his former business partners also took his Lamborghini away.
Oh, man. Took his baby.
Yeah, they took his baby. Exactly. Baby. And it turns out
that was his car.
That would be
Grand Theft Auto.
So, you know, we found a sore spot with this guy, and it is for sure the car.
Yeah.
So they say that the car was reportedly purchased by the Hit Network that owned BitBoy, and the company took back the car in order to recoup funds that they say that he stole.
Try like explaining this to someone who's like 80 years old.
Exactly.
The Hit Network tried to take away BitBoy's money from the crypto. Like, huh? What on earth? What reality am I in?
What?
Is this the new Star Wars? No, you understand. BitBoy was on gas station pills, and the Hit Company wanted it. He got $40,000 for it.
And they took his Huracan.
They took his Huracan. You're scaring me. I want my nerves.
Wild world, man.
So, BJ Investment Holdings, the parent company of the Hit Network, took decisive legal action in removing Ben Armstrong from the company. BitBoy Crypto said in August that Armstrong is also concurrently facing a $1 billion class action lawsuit for his promotion of FTX. Jeez. So, this is one of the suckers that Sam Bankman-Fried has taken down with him at the moment, which fucking awesome.
$1 billion lawsuit, too?
Yeah, yeah. So, he's out of money. They took his Lamborghini and he's getting sued for $1 billion.
Still got them tracksuits.
Yeah.
If I was getting sued for $1 billion but was broke, I wouldn't give a fuck at all. Nah. What are you going to do? Yeah. Take my $0?
Yeah. They already took my car.
He had fun until they took his Articon away.
Yeah. Yeah. So yesterday.
Go from driving a Lambo to like a Civic either. That's got to be the most painful.
I'd be like, yeah, welcome to the fold, brother. Yeah. It's not so bad. I have the blue one. Great gas mileage.
You ever see Lambos? I mean, we live in LA. I see Lambos all the time. And I always like, man, that life has to be ridiculous. Zooming down Melrose.
Well, but not even
$300,000 car.
Not even zooming. That's why it always bothers me, is because it's such stop and go traffic here. You're just hearing like.
I saw someone get pulled over in a Corvette on Fountain, and I was like, yes. I was being a hater. I really was.
Hey,
you know what I found out about Ferraris is we could probably buy one in our lifetime if we say like a used Ferrari.
Oh yeah,
it's like $60,000
totally.
We should pool our funds.
They lose their value if people drive them. Like,
right, yeah.
Literally. Like,
oh, yeah.
Way more than a normal car.
Teslas, I see $20,000 Teslas on Craigslist all the time.
Right. But do those catch on fire or no?
No. The good ones.
Okay.
The current ones.
Okay. Ideally, we'd all be driving those fucking things. Oh, yeah. You know what
coming
I mean?
Coming soon. Yeah. We'll all have a Civic soon.
Yeah. And I like that they've made the glass bulletproof so that when it catches on fire, you can't escape the car. Isn't
that glass bulletproof now?
I've just been following the saga of the Tesla, the Cybertruck, and it's been fucking incredible.
Oh, but the Cybertruck thing's incredible.
And that was one of the things was there. You know, he's like, we will have bulletproof glass in the car, and you're like, your car's catch on fire. What are you? You can't do that.
When he dropped that, when the Cybertruck came out, and I saw the commercial. And I was like, oh, this is kind of ugly,
yeah,
but kind of cool. You know, then it was like, and then he did the whole bottle thing.
The
glass broke, and I'm like, oh, Elon shouldn't be doing any of this stuff. He should have somebody doing this for him.
Take it out of why? Because he's the most unlikable man on the planet.
He's stupid as fuck.
And he's an idiot.
I just think you would know that by now, and just like have like you know somebody like I would have Tom Brady doing all this stuff. I just pay him a lot of money. Everybody loves Tom.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
Tom has those shitty Hertz commercials.
Yeah.
He's jumping on couches. People still love him.
Yeah, yeah.
Just have Tom do all that. Just
get Weird Al Yankovic to do it. Like, everyone likes one Weird Al song.
Yeah.
It's smart, man. You got to know where you are and let other people do shit.
They would have to lean into it, though, of just him coming up and being like, I'm playing the part of Elon Musk today.
Why not?
Yeah. So he's in a lot of financial trouble and they jacked his car. Yesterday, Armstrong tweeted, quote, I'll be going live soon from a very special location on YouTube. So get ready. This is going to be good.
Whenever someone posts, I'm going to go live soon, I'm like, this is the worst announcement thing ever.
I always think they're going to kill themselves. I'm like, are you going to kill yourself on YouTube? Don't do that.
So after the tweet was published, Armstrong began an unhinged YouTube live stream that is still available on his YouTube as of this recording. With thousands of people watching, he drove while shouting and making legal threats. Quote, ask me how I'm doing, he said, before taking off his sunglasses and looking wildly at the camera. Ask me how I'm doing.
When he was driving?
Yeah.
What car was he driving?
TOS violation. What was it?
It appeared to be a Chevy Avalanche, but I'm not positive.
Okay.
Just based on what happened next.
Going back to his roots.
Yeah.
This has no Lambo.
He says, ask me how I'm doing twice. He says, I am doing better than ever now that I know that my boss has basically extorted and blackmailed and freaking launched a coup on me. He then danced to Soulja Boy's 2007 hit Crank That Soulja Boy.
BJ.
I called it 20 years in the past. Listen to Soulja Boy buying custom grills with logos in them.
You dude.
He's a big fan.
He's in Atlanta.
Yeah. It makes yeah. sense. Oh, there's so much just like dirty Atlanta shit going on with this story. It's incredible. So,
and he's blaming his boss for all of this.
Yeah. So the videos that circulated on Twitter later that evening, Armstrong live streamed himself outside of his former boss, Carlos Diaz's home. So that's where he was driving. Was he
to Carlos Diaz's house?
Pulls up in front of this guy's house
in an avalanche.
And it's like a suburban cul-de-sac in Atlanta. Like there's no one else on the street, and he just has a phone in front of his face and proceeds to rant for like 37 minutes while like just yelling at the house and stuff like that. He said things like, "I'm not scared of you, Carlos," and "Carlos has my Lamborghini. It's right here in his garage."
This girl.
So the rants became increasingly loud, and the already out there accusations got even wilder. They included the suggestion that the Houston Mafia was involved in BitBoy Crypto YouTube channel, and that 85-year-old California Congresswoman Maxine Waters had ordered a cryptocurrency influencer to be stabbed with a syringe full of fentanyl. I love that he's dragging Maxine Waters into this. Like, why is she catching strays, man? What did she fucking do?
Stab people with cocaine needles?
Fentanyl. Apparently. Apparently, Maxine Waters was like, "Kill this other crypto influencer." like, what the fuck does she care?
I can see Maxine doing it. She does look like, you know, like she could be real sorcery and evil sometimes.
Don't talk too loud. She lives right down the street.
I know.
She's in Hancock Park.
I know. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. So, unfortunately for Armstrong, during the stream, he appeared to admit to a number of additional crimes, including attempts to extort Ben.eth, who was another crypto influencer, for 300 Ether.
So yeah. Honor amongst thieves.
So,
these people.
Just in the middle of screaming, he just starts admitting to other crimes, which is great.
And I thought he was like, he was dropping dimes on someone else or something.
No, I think he's talking about all the dirty shit he had to do to work for this company. But yeah, I've got a few selections from the video if you guys want to see them.
Sure.
So let's go ahead and fire this up. You can see this is him out in front of this house.
Carlos has my Lamborghini right here in his garage. So today, guys, I'm going to be live streaming, and I'm going to be telling the entire story of Carlos Diaz.
He's so out of breath.
Yeah.
He's
furious.
Who Carlos Diaz?
He is absolutely pissed.
Oh, man.
My man is.
Poor BJ.
Oh, yeah.
That's a borrowed avalanche, too. You can tell.
Sure.
It's totally borrowed.
Oh, sure. We're going to get to who else is in the car.
If I borrow that car.
that actually becomes important a little bit later.
Carlos does. Well, at first he comes in, he's friends, went to a football game with me, went to a baseball.
Waka Flocka baseball.
Comes to my building. Love Waka Flocka. Great guy. I don't think he has anything to do with this. Love Waka Flocka.
So,
Waka Flocka?
Yeah, Waka Flocka's involved.
I love Waka Flocka.
He's a great guy.
I don't think he has anything to do with this. Yeah.
So is he like just name dropping during this insane rant, or is he?
He name drops every like semi famous rich person in Atlanta. Seemingly gets dropped at some point. He's talking about like players for the Falcons and fucking random
former Brave.
Yeah, just like
Greg Maddux, really nice guy.
yeah, exactly. And he's just one presumes just snorting pre-workout this whole time, just
sure
everything short
otherwise
of,
known as cocaine.
Right He's everything short of actually doing the I'm so excited scene from Saved by the Bell with his diet pills here, but
I'm so scared.
Please, there is no cool calm and collected for me. I'm emotional. These people have tried to destroy my life, and I'm standing up for it, and I'm saying no more, Carlos.
Oh, man. Oh, somebody's going to loop that, man. No more, Carlos.
Yeah,
that's going to be on somebody's track soon.
That's
no more,
be a
Carlos.
No more, Carlos.
No more, Carlos. I'm standing up for myself.
Any upcoming producers named Carlos.
Yeah.
Good drop for the beginning of your
no
songs.
No more, Carlos.
This is my favorite
here. It's just a neighbor. You guys see? When I see a car coming down the street, I have to think about protecting myself. That's where I'm at, guys. This is not paranoia. This is not a crazy person. This is not someone who is erratic. This is not someone who is on drugs.
So, as we said many
times, also like the light has changed in the video. He's been out there for hours.
He's been there so long. He's gotten right past golden hour into it's getting dark.
Some mosquitoes out there right now.
Oh, hell yeah. As we said many times on the show, if you've reached a point where you're just going, I'm not fucking crazy.
yeah, you are, but
check yourself.
He streamed for 37 minutes.
Yes.
And he had his phone fully charged.
I believe because he's wearing like a fanny pack around his shoulders. I'm thinking maybe he had like a battery or something in there.
He's a real streamer.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
This is his first rodeo. This is his first live stream.
You got to copyright that.
Yeah.
Serial streamers. That's a good one.
So, yeah, after streaming for, by the count of this video, maybe even longer, but for about 20 minutes, finally the police show up. And because Carlos obviously is like, there's a maniac screaming in the cul-de-sac outside of my house. But so the police pull up, and I did just want to share this one little moment because this is fucking outstanding. And this goes into who I believe the Chevy Avalanche belongs to.
Where in the car is your gun?
It's in the back seat.
Back seat?
Yep.
Is anybody else in the car?
Yes, there's somebody in the car.
Who's in the car?
Who? What's that?
Who's in your car?
Who's in my car?
Yes.
Okay. Let's,
Who's in your car?
Who's in my car?
Who's in your truck, sir?
Cassie is in my car. Cassie's in my truck.
All right, Cassie.
Cassie's in my truck. My wife knows that we're here, by the way. She knows we came to do this. But my wife is aware. So we're live on YouTube right now.
So
did he just out himself for cheating on his wife?
He did. He totally did.
He
absolutely did.
Dude. Your life is done, man.
This is why.
She's just set it up front.
Look, as epic as it is to stream while you're getting arrested.
Yeah.
The police are going to ask you some questions you have to answer.
I'm sure he put a lot of thought into this going into it.
Clearly.
That was probably planned. All this was probably planned.
He was just sitting there in his tracksuit, sweating, listening to Soulja Boy tell that over and over, just getting crazier and crazier.
Watching a guy like that announce his L's really loud like that.
He's just sitting there like, I will Superman that hoe. I'll do it now.
You know? Heartbreaking, man. Just lose everything like that.
Yeah,
brutal.
Oh, it's so brutal.
So his tweet from today, I am not getting rid of Cassie, period. My own friends and family lied and manipulated me in the worst ways to accomplish their goal of breaking us up, and I will never give them what they want. Never! So
you got a picture of Cassie in there?
I couldn't find one. I was trying to find one. I believe that's her Avalanche.
I'm sure that's Cassie's Avalanche.
If the Huracan is his only means of transportation, then he had to borrow somebody's car.
Side chick car like any other car would. Avalanche? Totally.
Well, yeah, side chick.
I'll get you this Cadillac Escalade adjacent car.
It's side chick car, but it's also like my favorite thing, which tells you he asked to borrow his wife's car, and his wife was like, I want nothing to do with this.
Smart.
And so he calls Cassie, and she's like, I'll be right over, baby.
I got you.
Yeah,
I got you, boo.
I got you.
Cassie's a stripper for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. When he first started responding, I was like, oh, he picked up a prostitute.
Exactly.
He's reacting as if he's done something very wrong.
Yeah.
Who's in the car?
Just that little moment he makes where it's like the whole like, hey, my wife knows about this. Like that is like, we will deal with it after the stream.
Yeah.
And this is for the followers to know, not for my wife.
And for context for people listening, he puts the phone on the ground.
Right.
And so you could still see him like kind of talking to the cop, and he turns and looks down at the phone when he says it.
Right. Yeah.
Jesus
Which
Christ.
Is just a level of insanity that is.
Don't worry, man.
I really
Your
appreciate
wife isn't watching. She's been ignoring you for probably months now.
Yeah. Yeah. Especially now that you've got a $1 billion lawsuit. She's looking for ways out.
She's trying to get that side crypto money.
Yeah. You know, yeah.
That Bitcoin in another account, you know.
So Motherboard called the Gwinnett County Sheriff's Department, and a media relations officer confirmed that a Benjamin Charles Armstrong was arrested on Monday night for simple assault as well as loitering and prowling. Bail was set at $2,600, and he has since been released. So
his name is BJ Armstrong.
It is indeed.
That's
yeah.
Hilarious. Shout out to the Chicago Bulls.
Yeah. But he made a tweet earlier today saying that he had been in jail overnight for loitering. Now here's the best part. So that part that I played you starts after he has knocked on the door of this guy's house.
Diaz's house.
Of Diaz's house. So now that that has been released, Diaz came out with his own video.
Okay.
Which,
how tall is Diaz? Seems like he's about 5'2". Short man.
Diaz comes out with his own video, which shows from his ring cam, which actually shows what Benjamin did here. And he did put funny meme music on it. So he knocks on the door, he kind of starts to film, and then he hears a bunch of dogs, and what does he do? Oh, that's right. He ran away.
Yeah.
So that's when the video starts, is him out of breath running up the tiny little hill back up to the avalanche, being like, he's in there and he knows that I'm here.
Got them dogs waiting for me.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why he's out of breath.
BJ had on slides too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Come on, man. This dude does nothing.
So
Rivers, are all crypto guys going to end up like that?
Oh, you know.
No, Carter, they're going to be all right.
I was going to say.
Okay. It's called the crypto arena now, so it seems like it's got to be legitimate.
Dude, what are they going to do with that? And they sponsor the UFC for like $50 million.
Oh, boy.
There's no way they have the money to pay that.
Get out. Get out while you can if you got that money.
Well, what's going
to
happen
to us.
That's the thing.
The Woods Arena.
Somebody is going to get a hilariously cheap deal on that name here when they have to liquefy their assets. That'll be one of the first things to go.
Yeah, the Pornhub Arena.
That would be amazing. So? That would be incredible.
They would never allow
they,
it.
They wouldn't allow no, it, but boy. Yeah.
I mean, you never know, man. I mean, it's cool. Weirder things have happened in the city.
Give it 20 years.
Yeah.
OnlyFans Arena.
I can see OnlyFans.
OnlyFans is getting very close to being like. Well,
and also it makes sense because it's like a sports arena, so it's for the fans.
And old people don't know what like OnlyFans is.
That right,
doesn't
right.
sound as bad. I mean, we know.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Right. Pornhub is like, Pornhub? Our dads know what that is. But not OnlyFans.
Pornhub basically is called Whack Shack. I mean, like, OnlyFans sounds like it could be like a crowdsourcing thing.
Yeah.
Or a sports thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
OnlyFans.
It could be like, you're Los Angeles Lakers. Who do we do it for? Only the fans.
Only fans.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Uh-huh. So. This is so dirty.
Yeah. No,
I mean, judging from billboards around town, it'd probably be the Sweet James Lawyer Arena.
Oh, Sweet right. James. Yeah, yeah, Sweet yeah. James Arena sounds great.
Sweet James.
That guy's got some advertising.
Dude, it'd be something even everywhere. More like ephemeral. It would be like fucking like season 3 of Stranger Things Arena. You know what I mean?
For
like,
your consideration.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, yeah.
Just for your consideration.
Yeah, for your consideration arena.
Oh fuck, I love that.
It's like, have you guys won everything?
Yeah. Yeah,
you got looks, you got money, you gotta win this fucking award for your shitty show.
I hate that shit where it's man. The chances of a sports arena opening in Los Angeles and just being called the Los Angeles Arena or Los Angeles Stadium is done.
Oh, never will happen again.
You know?
Too much money in it.
Yeah.
It's like the most capitalist city in the world. So, yeah, of course. Like a company is going to, you know, the Snickers Arena or something fucking, you know, McDonald's.
Smoothie King Arena.
Shout out to New Orleans. Yeah, that's still the arena.
That's still the name of it.
As far as I know, yeah.
Smoothie King Arena.
Unless it's changed recently. The last time I was in New Orleans, I feel like
shit is called the Jamba Juice Arena.
Oh my God. Dude. The Depends Arena.
Oh, see, yeah.
It's coming, dude. And then you get like a bunch of cheerleaders out wearing adult diapers and shit. Dude, yeah. have to really sell it.
No shame.
Yeah. But yeah, no, to answer your original question, are all these people going to go to jail? It seems like slowly some of them, but it's going to be the people who are not already attached to the existing structure of finance.
I should pull out all of my money?
Just look up who this person's dad is. If their dad already works for Merrill Lynch, dude, then no, don't worry about it.
I spent all of my family's money on NFTs. Is that a bad idea?
They're coming back.
Okay, good.
There was just like an article that I just read where it was like 99% of NFTs are below
$10.
Worthless. Yeah.
But some people made some good money off of that. You know,
I mean,
I commend anybody that jumps in a game and gets all the money they can and gets the fuck out.
Yes.
Absolutely. Strike when the iron is hot. If you can understand that principle, then for sure.
Get out. Man, I love it. Like those GameStop people.
Oh, yeah,
that
sure.
Jumped into that shit and got like a couple grand or, you know, 50,000 and got out.
And now there's a movie coming out.
There's a movie. Yeah.
Same thing in Vegas. If you go there and you're like a little ahead, you got to know when to like stop yourself.
Get out.
No one to hold them, no one to fold
them. That's it, man. That's the name of the game.
If you got the money, I've got the time. We'll go honky tonkin' and we're gonna have a time. Bring along your Cadillac, leave more wreck behind. If you got the money, honey, I got the time.
We have a segment on the show where we talk about our guest's hometown. And today, Greg joins us from the beautiful city of Hampton, Virginia.
Hampton, Virginia. Beautiful city. I haven't heard that much.
Is it not?
Thank you.
I've actually never been to Hampton. The things I know about Hampton is basically just the Battle of the Monitor versus the Merrimack happening. Yeah. And then they named a damn bridge after it. Mm-hmm. So the very first naval battle between two ironclad ships, there was a Confederate ship and a Union ship, and they shot at each other for 2 days and neither one of them sank. So it's the most anticlimactic battle ever, but it is very interesting because when it happened, word went out all over the world that these two ironclad ships, they sunk a shitload of wooden ships, but neither of those went down, and Britain and France stopped their wooden ship production in their navy. Like, that's how quick it was. They're like, okay,
we're done.
This is a new page.
Yep. Like, we gotta start making these type of ships.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So
we've always been on like the forefront of violence.
Oh yeah,
and the war.
Yeah, absolutely.
We in America do it well.
Oh hell yeah! And where I'm from, we make all the ships.
Yeah.
That's if you're in Newport News is big shipbuilding. If you grew up where I'm from and say you didn't graduate from high school, or if you did graduate from high school and you didn't want to go to college, you just wanted to stay home, you go work at the shipyard.
At the shipyard,
and
yeah.
You just build, you weld, and you make all the fucking Navy ships. And you got a good life until they start laying off people. And they always lay off people. But I think, who was it? When Trump came through maybe 4 years ago, and he was like, we're going to make 20 Navy ships. And everybody back home was like, fuck yeah. 20 ships?
Yeah.
It's like, yo, you're going to be working there for at least 80 years.
Yeah, I was going to say, right. That's at least 80. It takes a long fucking time to build
ships,
those things.
Yeah. So everybody's good.
Are they actually doing that, or was that just...
I think they're doing
it. Okay.
I think they're trying to at least... I mean, even if you cut those 80 ships into 40... I mean, from where I'm from, that's like, those people are like, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. We're good.
Yeah. I tried to figure out why it's called Newport News.
I have no, I mean, Christopher Newport is the reason. And the James River Bridge.
Yeah. It's named for him. The only thing I found was there's like a folk tale that supposedly he left Jamestown to go get supplies, found them at what would become Newport, and came back to Jamestown with good news. Mm. Hence Newport News. Yeah, but I always heard that. I remember listening to like the Ken Burns Civil War documentary. They would mention Newport News. And I was just like,
it's crazy.
Why is that the name of a town?
Newport News, Jamestown. I mean, we went to Jamestown as kids, like every year.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's got to be all Griffith Observatory.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah.
To see the Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Marie. To cook cornbread like they used to cook cornbread. And all that shit.
They don't pan fry it.
Salt water taffy. Yeah, they used to pan fry it. It was nuts, man. It's church, military, and football.
So it's America.
Pretty much.
Yeah. And that's it. First English settlement in America, Jamestown.
I was going to say, it's like the American city, right?
Really
that's
is.
Right. Yeah.
Hella ghosts.
We're going to get to
hella ghosts.
Oh, we got to get into ghosts.
So many wars, man.
Yeah, absolutely.
So many ghosts out there.
Yeah. I did find out this is the hometown of two great musicians. I'm sure there's more, but the two that I found on the list, Steve Earle is from Hampton.
Cool.
And also maybe the greatest bass player of all time, Victor Wooten, is from from Hampton as well. So and then also Allen Iverson is from Hampton.
Oh man, everybody's from Allen Iverson, Michael Vick, Missy Elliott, Pharrell, Timbaland.
Yeah,
I mean, so many football and basketball and Teddy, so many musicians.
Out of all
is
those
clips
rivers,
from
no,
the clips, the clips is from Norfolk.
Push a T and all the
I looked specifically at Hampton, so it's in a cluster of cities. So there's Virginia Beach, Hampton,
it's seven cities.
DMV area.
DMV is more Delaware, Maryland, Virginia, but where I'm from, it's like it's called the 757. That's our area code, but it's like seven cities. Connected almost like the seven boroughs in New York. Hampton, Newport News, Portsmouth, Chesapeake, Suffolk,
Norfolk,
and Virginia Beach.
So I just looked up specifically Hampton, but there's a shit. I mean, Ella Fitzgerald is from the area.
She's from Newport News.
Yeah, there's a ton of
New
people.
York.
Yeah,
there's a lot of musicians. That
totally,
come out.
We have
Virginia Beach. Yeah, that's Pharrell. That's Missy Elliott, as you mentioned. Well, let's get into these questions here about Hampton, Virginia.
All right.
Let's make Hampton come alive.
Yeah.
So first up, what was the incident?
the biggest incident that Hampton has that probably people still talking about actually deals with Allen Iverson.
Oh, no shit.
It's his, when he was in high, like Allen Iverson was like the Mr. Big Shit when he was in like high school.
Right.
And he, there was this bowling alley called Spare Times. And I think this was his junior year. And there was this big brawl at the bowling alley. It was like a racial brawl. And people were throwing chairs and shit. And Allen Iverson actually wasn't really involved in it, but he was there. And he went to like, they sent him to jail. They sent him to City Farm and shit.
Damn.
And the town just had like this big, like uproar. And his whole senior year was, he was in jail. And then the governor actually pardoned him. And that's how he went, ended up going to Georgetown. So like, that's like one of the biggest stories. It's been on ESPN. The fucking bowling alley is still there.
Yeah, you bowled there before?
Oh, I've bowled there many times, before and after.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's like probably like the big incident that happened in my hometown.
Okay.
Yeah, but they've given them fucking parades. They love
it. Well, yeah. Is it Allen Iverson Day like there now?
Oh, yeah. They did all the makeup shit. Oh, we're sorry. Yeah. We're sorry for ruining your high school.
Yeah, right.
But yeah, thank you for being all you are and putting us on the map and shit. Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. I think we talked about this on the show. Dr. Pat, co-host emeritus, found a $8,000 mink Allen Iverson jersey.
Yeah.
On Real on that, sure, on that website.
I'm sure.
And I just remember seeing it like, this is the ugliest item of clothing. Because also a jersey, the idea is to kind of keep you cool.
Yeah,
this mink thing is made out of fucking mink fur.
Mink?
Yeah, it was mink. Oh, it was fucking,
he's
awful.
Wild. Yeah. He's a wild dude.
Yeah. I don't know if it was even his necessarily. But also at the same time, I was like, who else would this have been?
Oh, somebody probably made it for him.
And he was like,
please take this.
Yeah, please. Yeah, just don't. Please take put this. It in a box and just send it to Real Real. Question two. Local legend.
Allen Iverson, Michael Vick. Those are probably, I mean, those are our local legends, though, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are our hometown
dudes. Is there anyone you know, like, you knew personally, perhaps?
Oh, I knew Vic personally.
No shit. Oh.
I know Michael Vick.
Oh, wow.
Like, I haven't seen him in years, but if I saw him, he would know who I am. And yeah, damn, he'd be like, what's going on? Yeah, I know. We play football against each other.
No shit. Okay.
Actually, really, really nice guy.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, really, I believe it.
Got caught up in some.
He did his time.
Dumb shit.
You know.
I mean, the quietest dude. Quiet, nicest guy ever.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow. Sad, man. When he got caught up in that shit, I felt so bad for him.
Yeah.
Because it was just like a country rich dude that had all these hanger-ons around him and got caught up doing some dumb shit that he shouldn't have been doing.
Encouraging him to participate in foolishness.
Yeah, exactly.
That he was above.
He was like, I mean, he can't even do this shit. I gotta like study for these games, and I gotta come home and y'all are fighting dogs at my Suffolk property. Suffolk is like the hick town of like the seven cities. You know
okay.
what I mean? It's like the really like, whoa,
yeah.
You going to Suffolk? What you doing out there to fuck your cousin? You know? That's Suffolk out there.
It's the Virginia part of Virginia Beach.
It's the West
it's like
Virginia
a, it's
part
like a toll
Virginia.
Bridge. It's just the guys like here to fuck your cousin or
business or pleasure?
Pleasure, right?
And he bought a house out there because it's so much land.
But,
yeah, I felt bad for him. Now, his little brother is the fuck up. His little brother is, you know, these guys came from nothing and to live in the projects, and then your like sophomore year in high school, you got a Benz and all this jewelry and big money and shit. Of course you're gonna go crazy as a high school kid, you know?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Shout out to Ron Mexico.
Jesus. I loved it. What a great name though, right? Yeah, I need to get my Valtrax medicine.
For those who don't know.
Yeah, I was gonna say
his alias he would use to pick up prescriptions.
Herpes medicine.
And also check into hotels as Ron Mexico.
That arouses so much more suspicion.
As far as made up names, comedians couldn't come up with a better one.
I've always been partial to Anthony Weider's Carlos Danger.
Carlos Danger.
Yeah, I do like Carlos Danger. I don't know why everybody just immediately tends to like Spanish names, but it does make it funnier.
Ron Mexico.
My name is Cesar Germany.
Yeah. Excuse me. It's pronounced Mexico. Question three. Worst bar And as I say many times, worst can mean best. All my favorite bars are dumps.
I mean, I left Virginia like at 20, so I wasn't really going to bars. But we did have like a strip club that I used to like sneak into when I was like 15 and 16.
What was that called?
Fake ID. It was called the Dew Drop In.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Dew Drop In. Wooden, like a wooden stripper platform stage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I was 15 the first time I went in there with one of my friends' college ID.
Yeah.
Yeah. when Coronas were like a dollar.
Oh, man.
Just a wild
when
world.
When you get out into like the middle of America, beer is cheap again.
Yeah.
It used to be cheap as fuck. I mean, I don't know how much a beer is now in Virginia.
Yeah, probably like $3.
$2 Coronas is like, what the fuck? $2.
Yeah. At least like $6, not like fucking $12 here.
Oh, yeah. When I first started stand up, I got the first show I ever produced was at a place in Auburn called the Big Blue Bagel.
Mm-hmm.
And they had just opened up at night and gotten like a license to sell beer and wine. And the manager who I was friends with was like, yeah, no, nobody's like, nobody comes in here at night, even though we're open. I'm like, it's a fucking bagel place. Why?
Who wants bagels at night?
And I had just started doing stand-up, so I was like, what if you gave me like one night out of the month, you know, and we could run a show out of there? And so I started the show there, and I was like, all I'll need is a beer special. If you just give me like a cheap beer. And so the first show I ran, and this is only 2011, so not that long ago, $1 PBRs, $2 Blue Moons. Jeez. All night.
That's a wrap. People are there for sure.
We had the fire marshal called a couple of times.
But it's like, it's also like the rents aren't as astronomically high. Right. So not as everyone's just like hoarding alcohol. So they're like, let me have 36 beers then. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? Like, everyone's just like, oh, yeah, that's a nice little deal.
Hell yeah. Social drinking for a dollar?
Yeah. That's where Carter and I met, actually.
Yeah.
It was at the Big Blue Bagel.
It's true. I used to work at the Birmingham branch of the Big Blue Bagel.
No shit.
Dude, the guy that ran that one. Oh, that's a story for another time. That guy was a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
Is it still around?
Yeah.
Big Blue Bagel.
Big Blue Bagel. Yeah. I ate there back in April when I was home.
Nice.
Yeah. But great food, though. The Tiger food. Melt.
Tiger Melt. Yeah, that's
dude,
it.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of food, question four, best local food. So what is like Virginia Beach kind of known for? Do they have a signature dish?
I mean, Virginia, you know.
You're still in the South at that point, right?
We are still in the South.
That's true. Cooking. But it's mid-Atlantic.
It's like where the South meets the North, you know, like Southern North Carolina people would call us like fucking Northerners.
Yeah.
And people from, you know, Baltimore would be like these fucking hicks. You know, they would call us, you know, like country bumpkins. But. A lot of seafood in Virginia. The name of my high school is called the Crabbers, right?
Oh, okay.
So a lot of fucking crab, blue shell crab, but soul food as well. One of the spots that's like famous in my hometown is a spot called Tommy's, which my wife hates. She's like, why is this shit? People love this shit. This shit's terrible.
Yeah.
But it's like home cooking meals and, you know, fried, you know, potatoes and just, you know, cheap pancakes and just a regular spot. But yeah, everybody loves the crabs out there.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's your favorite crab dish? Do you have one?
I'm not a big fan of crab.
Oh, okay.
You know, my family, when we have family reunions, we'd buy a bushel or two bushels of crabs and we'd make them.
Do the boil.
Do the bushels. Boy, and we'd cook them and we'd bring the tables out in our backyard with the newspaper and everybody sit around and eat crabs. But it's kind of labor intensive.
It is, yeah.
For the amount of meat that you get, like it's kind of.
Same thing with crawfish. Yeah, you're just eating the little tiny piece of meat to get your hands disgusting.
Yeah.
And I never was a fan, but the crabs are good. But nah, man, I'd rather have like real food.
Yeah.
Shrimp. I like shrimps.
Shrimp. Love a good shrimp.
Clam shrimps, you know.
Question five, and this is going to be a lot of this. Local ghosts or monsters?
Oh, man. Well, just, you know, with so many wars, so many, like, civil wars and just wars in general in Virginia from, like, the beginning of the country.
Yeah.
It's just a lot of weird shit. It's a lot of fences that, like, what's behind that shit? With all the military and shit?
You know?
I've seen so much shit as a kid, man, that I didn't know was, like, is this UFO shit or is this a ghost shit? Or is this just, like, spirit shit, you know?
They're
in all the churches and shit?
They're in league, the aliens and the ghosts.
Oh, for sure. And all that water?
Yeah.
I mean, man, I've seen so much random shit as a child that I'm like, man, I don't know what's real or what's not real.
Right.
I always knew as a little kid, though, that just like the stuff that like we know isn't everything. I knew like other shit was like possible.
Yeah.
Witch shit. Uh-huh. You know, I knew about witch shit as a kid.
Uh-huh. So no one's scoffing at the idea of ghosts or
not at all.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
okay, I don't know. Okay. Everybody's like, oh, you saw that shit? I remember, okay, I used to work at a dinner theater in Williamsburg, Virginia, which is kind of like maybe 30 minutes from where I'm from in Hampton.
Yeah.
And to get to the dinner theater, you take this freeway, which is this normal 664 freeway, but you get off and you have to go through like this forest for like maybe 5 minutes. But it's a long ass, it's like 3 miles, right?
Yeah.
It's forest. And the dinner theater, we get out like around 11. And, you know, after we're done counting our money tips and cleaning up and shit, and to go home, I'm driving through this like forest shit. And I remember one night I'm driving and I run, I'm like, it's only a 2-lane, you know, through this forest area. And I see a family walking
oh my God.
On the side of the street, right? And you know, if it's like 11 o'clock at night and some lights hit you, people are going to turn around.
Right, sure. Right.
Nobody turns around.
Oh, Jesus.
And I wasn't stopping.
Yeah,
so, you know, I just keep going. And then the next day when I go back to work, you know, when I work up there, those people actually live in Williamsburg. And I tell everybody, I'm like, yo, man, I saw this, like, family in this forest, and like it was like everybody stopped and was like, oh, you saw the Jenkins family that got lost in that forest 30 years ago.
No.
And random people always see it. And it was like, yeah, man, they told me the whole story. So yeah, it's hella ghost out there.
Wow.
Just weird shit. But yeah, it's Virginia, man.
I love it.
Yeah.
And finally, favorite thing that's not there anymore.
When I was a kid, the Grateful Dead used to play in Hampton.
Yes, yes.
Once a year. And I mean, where I'm from is like hella black. and then the Grateful Dead would come. And so it goes from like, and not just, I mean, it's just 80, 20. And then we have the military, so you have a lot of other races, but it's really black. And then like the Grateful Dead would come and it's just weird. And I remember like as a kid just watching this, like, who the fuck are these people, right?
Yeah.
Because people would like, I'd be at McDonald's, like, you know, I'm like 14, I'm at McDonald's or Taco Bell, you know, ordering like some fucking 69 cent tacos. And then you see this kid in like these fucking cut up corduroys.
Yeah.
Right. Or I want a burger, no meat. You know, like in 1994, and you're like, who the fuck orders a burger with no meat? And it's the Grateful Dead. So it kind of like,
I need a miracle, man.
Did people like show up to those shows or like,
hell yeah.
Packed out.
So like once a year you see all these types of people that you wouldn't like see on a regular basis. And that kind of like got me into mushrooms as a kid.
Okay.
I started like, you know, you meet these people, I'm like, what the fuck is going on? He's become cool. He's like, hey man, Greg, you ever heard of mushrooms? I was like, what the fuck is mushroom? Cow patties. And I'm like, what? Does he eat shit off of cow patties?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Greg, you think weed is good? This shit blow your mind. So like, yeah, I don't think the Grateful Dead does that anymore. I'm sure they
well
they, maybe they do.
Well,
maybe
yeah.
They do.
So they've got just recently they just finished up touring, but they had John Mayer take over Jerry Garcia's part,
and
they, because that's the whole thing with them is, and it's kind of what you were talking about, is basically there's the idea is like, okay, there's this band, and whether you go to the show or not doesn't matter. They're going to show up, and there's going to be a parking lot full of drugs.
Yeah,
and
<for sure. laughs>
so anywhere they went, it was like it was a big
thing.
And Hampton Coliseum, because the Grateful Dead, obviously they're done, but the group Phish, who kind of took up the reins from the Grateful Dead in the 90s, they put out kind of one of their famous live albums. It's called Hampton Comes Alive, which I had that one.
Right.
Yeah.
It's nuts.
It has a very embarrassing cover of Getting Jiggy With It, which was the number one song on the radio at the time.
Awesome. I didn't know they had a Hampton album.
Oh, that's great. That was like their first or their second big live release, I think. And it's six discs.
Yeah, people loved it, man.
Fuck yeah.
It must be, I mean, was it just like such a, is it geographically like a pretty place? Like,
it's
is that like where they're
The Hampton Coliseum is really cool looking, too.
Uh-huh.
And just the city, I mean, with all those trees and all that water, you know, it's gorgeous.
Yeah, that's the Hampton Coliseum.
Yeah, that's where you graduate from.
Oh, really?
You graduate from high school.
Is that where you graduated?
That's where we walked across,
dude. Whoa, dude.
That's where all the concerts, that's where I saw my first concert at.
What was your first show?
Biggie. It was like a...
Oh, shit. Oh.
The big radio station there is 103 Jams, and they would do a concert once a year, and it would only cost $1.03.
Uh-huh.
So, and like, they have big names out there. So the first one I saw, it was Biggie. It was like...
Wow.
I forget who else was there. Big Pun.
Yeah, oh, just, dude.
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, I was like maybe 14. That was my first concert I saw. But damn, yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Oh, that fucking rules. Yeah.
But that's the thing that's, I don't know if Fish still comes there.
Oh, yeah.
They still go there?
I mean, okay. They put out a famous record called Hampton Comes Alive. So the people expect
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah, they have to.
I used to fucking love that as a kid. You know, it's just interesting to see all these different people.
Yeah.
Like different drugs.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. Very
shout
different.
Out the mushrooms. Changed my world.
Oh, yeah. No, the first fish show I went to, it was Atlanta 2003. And I was, I think I was 16. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I remember just walking through the thing and everybody's selling fucking weed, oh, man. And a guy let me buy a fat tire even though I was 16, man. Yeah.
Good weed. I mean, good weed was so hard to come by. I didn't think I really got high.
People who didn't smoke weed in the 90s and early 2000s have no clue.
No clue.
That it used to be so bad.
It was
And
awful.
That was the standard.
That was it. You were happy to get that.
Those jam band shows seem like to be like the ultimate, like cops looking the other way while people just high as fuck.
Sure.
Yeah.
Since the 70s, you're like, well, like there is this place where people can just get high. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Yeah.
And the cops probably go in and try to shake them down. And there's like, here's $1,000. Let me sell acid all night long.
I think Virginia, you know, Virginia was like, fuck it. This is the one day. The one couple of days
right.
with this band,
yeah,
we're
yeah.
going to let everything slide and let everything cool.
Damn. Well, that is a tour of Greg Edwards,
yeah.
Hampton.
Hampton, Virginia.
Virginia.
Shout out to Hampton.
Chair won't go nowhere.
Fellas, we have time for just one more segment.
What is it?
This is our jam of the week. Oh, it's annoying. It must be bro country. This is Morgan Wallen. Featuring Florida Georgia Line with their 2018 awful song, Up and Down.
This whole era of bro country has escaped me. I've never heard this.
I heard this in the gas station the other day when I was in Orange County, unsurprisingly, which is the only place out here where you would hear such a thing. Yeah. And
this is one of those songs that is so like generically country that you could hear and never remember that you ever heard it in your life.
Oh yeah, no, I just heard the chorus, which is him going, "Bobber's going up, down, up, down." So it's like a fishing song, which, you know, we talked about beach songs, but this is a fishing song. So you know, and I will say the music video, not fishing, they're just on a boat, and the song makes a reference to BFE, which for those people who are not Southern, being stuck in the middle of BFE, that stands for bumfuck Egypt. That means the middle of nowhere. Yeah. Which hilariously, there was an episode of Robert Irvine's Mission or Restaurant Impossible, which was like his version of Gordon Ramsay's Hell's Kitchen or whatever. Not Hell's Kitchen, Kitchen Nightmares. And he went to a place in the middle of nowhere in Georgia, and it was called like the BFE Grill. And it's just fucking Robert Irvine being like, what does it mean? What does it stand for? What does it stand for? Just trying to make a man say bumfuck Egypt to him. So, but there was a lot of commenters that were very pissed that this was filmed in the Perdido Pass down in the border of Florida and Alabama near Gulf Shores, which is a pretty big city at this point. So people were just like, this is not bumfuck Egypt. This song is a lie. Like they were very upset about that. And also there was a lot of people saying that bobbers are for pussies. Yeah, so when you're
hilarious.
There was a lot of people being like, if you're using a bobber, you're a fucking asshole.
You're like, these are people who are like Jeff Gordon fans are pussies. Yeah.
Yes, 100%. We're like, no one cares.
It's the same sport.
No
it's
one
the same
gives a shit.
Yeah,
so no one on earth cares but you. So
you fish like a bitch.
Yeah, literally. There are so many people saying stuff like that. It's like, he's got bobbers. What do you mean? Like, what are you talking about?
We fish like men.
Yeah, yeah.
We sit down and fish.
Yeah.
Like real man.
Yeah. Look at him trying too hard, dude.
I don't need no non-binary bobbers.
You got
a
bobber. You got something floating with your fishing rod.
The line either is or it isn't. We don't need people floating at the top going
just
up and down.
Put it in the
war. Yeah, yeah. So, but yeah, this song, this video, I should say, has 193 million views.
Oh, yeah.
10,764 comments. And y'all, I read every last goddamn one of them. So now let us dive down into the comments for Up Down by Morgan Wallen and Florida Georgia Line. First up, Elite Sniper 14-8-X2.
Jesus.
From 2 months
ago. Someone report this person immediately.
Elite Sniper. Jesus Christ.
Armed and dangerous. It was like, flag that fucking guy.
I do love his comment. He says, "Hey, Morgan, in case you're watching, fuck you." I wish I share those sentiments as well. Morgan, if you're listening, fuck you.
Elite Sniper.
Yeah.
Wow.
Jesus. That guy plays a lot of Fortnite.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
He should put that in parentheses after.
Maybe that's what 148X2 means. It's some sort of Fortnite reference.
Oh, okay.
Susie G. Crafts from 3 years ago. You know when you've listened to too much Morgan Wallen? It's when you start hearing the bobbers in the pond going up, down during an intimate moment. Yep, here I am.
She fucking to this song?
Yeah.
So, for her.
There's a man on top of her, and she's just thinking, up, down, Jesus. Bobbers going up, down.
Damn.
Yeah.
That dick is like a bobber. That's a problem.
You're circular.
Circular and just barely going under the water. Yeah. Well, back up.
Really, like really skinny base for like a big bulbous head.
Right, yeah. It's like a bobber. It's an indication of good things to come, perhaps. But
you fuck like a bitch.
You and your bobber.
You fucking fish like a bitch. It's like hyper masculine.
Abby 321 from 11 months ago. Love your song. My middle name is Wallen. Last name is Wallen. So shout out to Abby Wallen.
I like that, honestly. I've never seen that before or heard about it, but that's great.
Middle names are, you know.
Abby Walla Walla Bing Bang.
I hope someone said that to her in her childhood. Walla Walla.
Christina Clifton from 11 months ago. You getting drunk or what? Because I'm just here. Just be here for Pennsylvania. Maybe I'm just not here. Maybe I'm not here for D's nuts.
Good for her.
Existential D's nuts joke is amazing.
She's getting fucked up.
Maybe we're all just one consciousness experiencing itself. D's nuts. Like, I love.
Got to win the crowd back with D's nuts.
Yes, absolutely.
Christina, was that her name?
Christina Clifton, yeah.
Christina Clifton. It's
the deepest thinker in Pennsylvania.
Yep.
R-D-U-N-L-V Me Too from 1 month ago. This is a great jammy. And this has Zippo to do with Hell's ruler, the devil. They mean Zippo if you know Jesus. Just saying.
Okay, Artie.
So I like that Artie goes to every song and sees if it's about the devil, and if it's not, then they leave the same.
He's not going with that intention. That just is what happens every time he interacts with everything in his whole life.
He just turns on Highway to Hell. He's like, not this one. Next.
Too much devil.
Well, he's like a guy who like walks into a 7-Eleven and he's like, nope.
Yeah.
I get a bad feeling about this.
Hey, if I'd have walked out of the 7-Eleven I went into where I heard this, we would have never gotten all these great comments. Hilarious. Like Randy Hansen 837 from 3 months ago. This song makes me want to be 40 years younger, buy a boat, move to Florida. Not necessarily in that order. Oh, and some hot college girls too. He spells hot, H-W-A-T.
Oh, what?
Hot college girls.
And so this guy's got to be at least 60 or 70. Yeah. If you want to be 40
years younger. Yeah. I'm 107.
He's a creep.
They're my college girls.
This song makes me horny.
And he says, and I want to be in a Morgan Wallen video. Yep, these are my life goals now. It's just H-E-H.
Hot.
Wap hot. Crazy Fasunke from 1 month ago. Five beers. High five, Morgan. You're a 10, Ranger. I'll see you in the October Sober Breeze. Players, and then there he is, the captain, Wallen. What for? Pollen sissies.
Pollen sissies?
Yes. Pollen I was sissies. Like, is this a guy with allergies, but he just plows through it?
Morgan Wallen is the Jeff Gordon of bro country.
I know. Yeah.
Have you guys heard pollen sissies before?
No.
Pollen
I've
sissies.
Never heard no. That. That's hilarious.
Yeah, I just
that's
imagine.
Someone with allergies is a pollen sissy?
Well, no. I like to imagine he also has like horrible allergies, yeah. But he just calls anybody who's taking Claritin a pollen sissy.
Pollen sissy.
This man is just his nose is just erupting snot. His eyes are bright red, and he's just like, "You're a bunch of pollen sissies."
Fucking pollen sissies.
Read his name one more time for those who have forgotten.
Oh, crazy the Sunke.
He told us. Told us he was crazy.
That's
at
true.
The very beginning.
That's true.
Fucking pollen sissies. Oh, I'm using that shit.
Yeah, yeah.
I am taking that shit.
All the people that complain about allergies in LA,
fucking
watch out.
Pollen sissies.
Pollen sissies.
I'm joking, people. That's what I'm saying. That on stage. Thank you, crazy fucking pollen sissies.
Got a few more here. Derek Bentley from 5 months ago. Rhythm and rhymes. And you pud whackers, you got Britney's number. Yeah, that type of summer can feel that type of summer can you feel coming? Pontoons together, 60 plus beers deep, midnight piss, drunk shits. What?
Fuck yeah, man.
I like that he's like sort of like invoking images of summer, and then he gets to the end and you're like, wait, stop, you went too far. Yeah. I don't, no one actually wants
tubing,
to think about
drunk shits, vomit,
midnight piss,
dying in your sleep.
As William Shakespeare said, shall I compare thee to a summer's day?
Yeah.
Shits that are drunken.
Grasshoppers, coke boogers.
60 beers deep.
60 beers deep.
Pollen bitches.
Pollen pussies.
Oh man.
This person here, they're sort of trying to dox somebody here.
Uh-oh.
Linda Lisk from 1 year ago. Make sure you go to Black Rock Bar and Grill. My baby is there. Hagerstown, West Virginia. Timothy Wayne Kilgore. Go eat there and scare him. Wow. He's good, yeah, okay. Boys.
All right.
I got you.
By what means?
I don't know. Yeah, just kind of like...
Go scare.
Just like have a knife on the table and just kind of look at him and look at the knife and then back and forth.
Or just like, you know, like rear pack a fist, like, fuck you.
Yeah, yeah.
Make him spill a drink.
Yeah.
What's her name again?
Oh, her name is Linda Lisk.
Linda Lisk.
Yeah. And
Linda told me to come here.
Yeah. Linda sent me.
Linda?
Linda from YouTube. You know her.
Oh, shit, really?
But yeah, it says, go eat there and scare him. He's good, boys. Tennessee Mountains. The world going to shit. My ex and my friends all suck, but they are all special. I saw pictures of your firstborn. Okay, now this is getting scary. I'm coming and I want my shit. Tennessee Mountains. Dolly Parton's titties are too big for me to understand. That's how you tap it off.
Oh, man. This is
they're
Diary
too,
of a Madman, dude.
Too big for me to understand.
Like, while I'm, while I'm at
sense.
It.
That's like, yeah.
That totally makes sense, though.
I'll tell you what.
Dolly Parton does have some. If you don't understand fake titties... Dolly Parton's titties will blow your mind. If you're a kid and you don't understand at all, like silicone, you're like, what the fuck, man? Why is she so old and those titties are so round? I don't get it.
So
your dad is like, sits you down and have a talk with you. He's like, those aren't real.
Sit down, Jeremiah.
Yeah, when we talk about just the unimaginable things on Earth, you know, we talk of Iwazu Falls. We talk about Stonehenge and Dolly Parton's tatas, bodacious tatas. And finally, and this sounds like a goddamn nightmare, Michael Wood from 5 years ago. The managers at the factory where I work have begun playing music over the loudspeakers. Every 2 hours, they play a different genre. One of those genres is modern country. Up Down is one of the songs that gets played every single day. And the song never plays when I'm on break and I can't hear the music. It only plays when I'm working. So it's like, this guy, quit your fucking job.
Well, does he like this song? Because he came here to listen to the song.
Yeah.
Or that's... did he just come here to make that comment? That this song drives me fucking so crazy. Much.
I get the impression that he's just being driven insane by this song.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's absolutely driving him up a fucking wall. But also, fair. Boy, get some, maybe you can. Maybe it's the sort of factory where you can't just have earphones in, but...
Probably not.
I feel like...
poor guy.
Yeah. I just like to imagine that the genres they're switching between aren't, you know, just pop music genres. It's everything. So you get a little Ornette Coleman, a little Beethoven. Just fucking, you know, some Mongolian throat singing.
Yeah, you get the noise music. Hours.
Yeah.
Oh, 9 o'clock. Time for ambient white noise.
like music that negotiators use to like draw people who are holding people captive out of like locations.
Yeah. It's time for 3 o'clock. It's time for Throbbing Gristle.
Yeah, here's Metal Machine music by Lou Reed. Yeah.
Oh yeah, and that is the absolutely unforgivable Morgan Wallen featuring Florida Georgia Line with their truly awful song Up Down. Our jam of the week. Greg Edwards, where can people find you on the internet?
You can find me at Greg Comedy on Instagram, Greg the Grouch on Twitter, or go to my website that I actually need to go to myself, Greg Edwards Comedy.
All right. Hell yeah. And
no, Greg Comedy, actually. See, that's how much I've
Greg Comedy.
GregComedy.com.
Hell yeah. Yeah. And Greg runs a very cool monthly show with past guests of the show, our friend Justin Lentz. Yep. It's called Farts. It's at public?
PDA Space.
PDA Space.
Public Displays of Altadena.
That's right. In Altadena. So.
I like that.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
It's weird as hell.
It is.
One time I met a guy out front named Killa.
Yeah.
Oh. And then he talked to me for a while, and then he made me leave because a girl pulled up in her car and he wanted to sexually harass her.
Oh, okay.
I would mess it up.
Yeah.
So he told me to go inside.
And he's like, get out of here for a second. He's like, ooh, you could be my new wife.
You gotta get out of the blast zone of my game. Hey, lady. La 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 la.
I want you to stay safe from this cancel it I'm about to get.
Yeah. Girl, I don't even understand your titties.
it is a place where people hang out in the parking lot sometimes.
Oh yeah,
get fucked up and totally. Blare music.
Hell yeah.
But otherwise, it's a very nice place.
Yeah, it's fun as hell.
Shopping center. Nice. Get some really shitty pizza up there. It's very great. Shitty.
Fuck yeah.
Tight.
Carter, where can people find you online?
Carter_Glasscock on Instagram, really. I might X again. Who knows? If the wind catches me, I might X.
But only if they start making everyone pay for it.
That's if they start making, look. I'm just a blue check mark and waiting. You know what I mean? I'm gathering, I'm rallying my troops to get a blue check mark, and then I'm out.
Hell yeah.
But no, you can read my music reviews on newnoisemagazine.com.
All right.
Do you love everything?
I've given a lot of positive reviews lately, and people have been messaging me and being like, you have no fucking idea what you're talking about.
Oh, wow.
But
people who read independent music magazines are
Dicks? friends of mine who are dicks to me.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, then that's fine.
Yeah. It's like, the record, it sounds terrible. I'm like, I liked it.
You're a fucking music pussy.
Yeah. On top of being a pollen pussy.
Pollen pussy.
Sam, where can people find you online?
Slam Harder on TikTok and Twitter, and SamHarder666 on Instagram.
Well, yeah, you can find me on Twitter, Instagram, Blue Sky, and Threads. I may one day post on those latter two, but in the meantime, I'll be at the former. And you can come see me do stand-up in Knoxville, Tennessee on December 17th. So I'm working on putting together a bunch of dates down south in December, but that's the one that I got hammered down. Venue TBA, but I'm definitely going there, so something's going to happen. We'll see.
Yeah.
So, anyway, you can find our show on Twitter at TheGoodsPod, every episode ever, plus new and classic clips dropping all the time at youtube.com/thegoodspod. The best way to support the show, head to patreon.com/thegoodspod. Second best way is to head to Apple Podcasts, rate, review, and subscribe. Show the attitude of gratitude, because if you do not have the attitude of gratitude, daddy, Bitboy will show up outside your house and start yelling about his Lambo.
BJ.
The Goods from the Woods was recorded and edited by me, Rivers Langley. You can find our show on Twitter at The Goods Pod. Our theme song was composed by Jonas, the Space Cowboy.
This was a Brain Freeze podcast.